two signal will be orthogonal when the integration of product of two signal equal to zero, then we'll say that two signals are orthogonal. Okay, then we have learned how to represent a signal if there are multiple or n number of mutually orthogonal signal is there. Okay, we have derived the equation or coefficient for that. That is Cj equal to integration minus integration t naught to t two. This ft is the signal which we have to approximate with the function orthogonal function Gz t dt by integration t naught to t naught t one to t two Gz square t dt. Okay, here this approximation, this coefficient, the equation is we have to approximate signal like c1 g1 t plus c2 g2 t plus up to cn gn t. My voice is clear?
Yes, sir.
So this, when we are going to approximate ft with this n number of orthogonal function, then our Cj, the coefficient, we can calculate coefficient with this equation. Okay, we can calculate each of the coefficients. Okay, corresponding coefficient of the this orthogonal function. If we require c2, then we will put here ft integration ft, here g2 will be put. The corresponding orthogonal function should be put in this place. Okay, and this will be g2 t. So like that, we can find any coefficient. Just we have to replace this Gz t function. So that's we have learned, and we also learned how to calculate or how to express MSE, mean square error. And we have learned that at the ultimate equation we have derived, that it is given by t2 minus t1. Integration integration t1 to t2 f square t dt for this case. Okay, minus summation r equal to 1 to n cr kr. Okay, so I have said that this here are the coefficient of this orthogonal function, and this, if this minus quantity will gradually increase the value, then our error will be decreased, and this will increase as we take the more number of orthogonal function. Okay, as we increase the orthogonal function from n, here n number of orthogonal function, if you n moves to infinity, then our error function would be tends to zero. Okay, so that means if we represent a function, if you try to approximate a function with a all number of orthogonal function, then the error will be zero. Then that the approximation function will replace with a equal sign. If we take all the orthogonal function, that it can be cooperate to represent the original function. Okay, if we increase the orthogonal function, then error will be decreases. So that's why the new topic has come, that is representation of a function. Write this topic, new topic. After this I have derived, I think this MSE, derived the expression for MSE. I have given the equation. And now next topic is representation of a function by closed or complete set of orthogonal function. Okay, what is mean by this? closed or complete set. What is mean by this? That up to epsilon, we know that if something function ft, we will going to represent by c1 g1 t plus c2 g2 t plus up to cn gn t. Okay, if we are approximate, then there will be error, and if we represent that error with MSE, then epsilon will be, we know that t2 minus t1 integration t1 to t2 f square t dt minus r equal to 1 to n, n number of orthogonal function we have taken, that's why r tends to 1 to n cr square kr this. Okay, I have said that as we increase the value of as we increase the orthogonal function, then our error will be decreased. If we take only one function, then error will be more. If we take two, then the error gets decreasing. And if we take the error up to n, then error will be very less. And if we take n tends to infinity number, then the epsilon or mean square error would be zero. Okay, the definition you can write, definition for this closed and complete set. What is called closed and complete set? You can write that the set of orthogonal signal or function which make the mean square error zero, okay, is called closed or complete set of orthogonal function or signal. Orthogonal signal. Understood? The all the set of orthogonal function which can make the MSE value zero is called a closed or complete set of the orthogonal function. Okay. You should know what is called closed and complete set. That's why this new topic I have written. It's in some of the question or some of the concept, there may be called that closed or complete set of orthogonal function has to be taken. That means the error would be on those representation will be zero. Have you written? And come to the next topic. Orthogonality in complex signal, okay? Till now, what we have taken the signal, all are real value signal. This is f1, g1, t, f2, which we have taken earlier, okay, previous classes, all are real signal. Now, what will be the derivation for complex signal? Many times this question asks, you have to write just the formula. Many times it asks, what is the orthogonality in the complex signal? Okay, for that the right secondly, that let us consider what is the formula for coefficient in the complex signal. That is the things similar with the previous concept only. Let us consider two complex signal, or function. You can write function also, signal also. F1 t and F to T, okay? In the interval T1, T2, then complex signal. Now F1 and F2 are complex signal, okay? Then F1 T can be represent, or approximate. Let me approximate first. Approximated using F2 as given by Uno, F1 T approximate sign C1 to F2 T. Okay, we are not no required to derive, just we need the formula. This is one approximation, which is the interval T1 to T2. Then what is the value of C1 to then? The value C1 to at which MSE, mean square error, will be minimum is similar with the previous only integration T1 to T2, only difference is F1 T F2 star, okay? This star should be put, conjugate means star T by T1 to T2 F2 T and F2 star T DT. Star means conjugate, complex conjugate. So this thing where you can write F2 star T means complex conjugate of F2. You just to know the equation, and in place of square here F2 T into F2 star T DT has come. Okay. Have you taken the note?
Yes, sir.
Okay. What is the equation for orthogonality? Let me, this thing should be zero. Let me give that one also. Are orthogonal over interval T1 T2 is if this T1 to T2 F1 T and F2 star T DT, or you can write star in the first function also, F1 star T F2 T DT should be zero, okay? The upper part should be zero, that's why if upper part is zero, then we will say that the signal is orthogonal. Orthogonal means the C12 value should be zero. That is our target. If C12 value is zero, then the two signal are orthogonal. Okay. But this equation I have given only when there is two function only, or you can say a function is represents with another single function. Okay, if we want to represent a function with n number of orthogonality function, then what will be the case? Okay, then orthogonal complex function or complex signal, what will be the case? You can write, suppose let me give g1t or g2t or up to gn t are complex, or you can write orthogonal complex function, you can write, then you can represent ft, you can approximate ft with c1 g1 t. You are not required to no need to derive all the sequence, just you should know the formula for complex signal c2 g2 t up to suppose cn gn t. What will be the cr or cn or cj, anything you can write, just t1 t2, just you have to give what you given here r, this gr you should give. If you write n here, gn you have to give. If you write cj, gj you have to give here, t dt integration t1 to t2 grt and gr star t dt. This is the case if there has n number of orthogonal function to represent a function ft. If you completed this, let me know. You can write in the chat box also.
Sir, completed.
So till now we have completed this representation with the orthogonal function. Okay. Here we have learned so many things, like a vector or a signal analogy, then signal space, then MSC, okay, then complex functions representation for approximation. And with this concept, let me give one numerical only. After that, we'll go for learn about Fourier series. Okay, let me give one numerical. Problem: a rectangular function ft is given by suppose ft equal to 1 when this and minus 1 when t goes by. Okay, this is one function has given, and say question say approximate approximate this function. Okay, by a waveform here it's given sin t. Only one function is given. Okay, approximate this function with sin t over the interval, over the interval zero to twice pi, such that the mean square error is minimum. Okay, so we already know there is two function. One function is there, another function is there. Okay, there is nothing take more function. Okay, only two function is taken. So and say that represents this with this, and we can write. We know that a function, suppose this, a function ft can be approximate with other function. Suppose this sin t is f to t, okay? Suppose sin 2 is f to t, ft can be represented with another function, then c 1 to 1 coefficient has come, then this will come, okay? This here f to t is nothing but sin t. We can approximate this f to with sin function. Only we have to give one coefficient c 1 2. Now our aim is to find the C12. How will find? Okay. Formula we know, and let me give a graphical also. The function is given this 0 pi cos pi. Okay. This function said make it sinusoidal or approximate in terms of sinusoidal signal. Okay. So what will be the How will be the coefficient? What is the coefficient such that we can make this square to sine wave? Okay, what will be the error then? The error should be minimum. This he said. The question said. So what happened? MSE will be minimum. Minimum.
Sir, previous slides. Completed, sir.
So MSE will be minimum if when we know the formula C12, we have to find C12, which is unknown for us. The limit is given twice by Ft. Okay, then F22, you write F22 because F2T I have taken here. Okay. F2T dt by 0 to twice by F2 square T dt. Okay. So you have to find this C12 now. And we have the function. This is pi, this is twice pi, this is 1, this is minus 1. And for sin case also, we know pi twice pi, okay? So, suppose we take a denominator, okay? Or take the numerator, no problem. Take the denominator first. What is given? 0 to twice pi ft. F2t dt. Okay. If you break here, this is the only pi, 0 to pi, f1 below is 1. F2 is what? It is given sin t. Understood? Plus, if we take pi to twice pi, okay, if we take pi to twice pi, then it is minus 1 because this function ft is minus 1. This is ft. This is ft. This is f2t. Okay. So minus 1 and sin t dt. So this is nothing but minus cos t pi 0. Or you can write minus sin minus, or write it once again, minus cos 2s pi by pi. Okay. What will be the value of this? Value is minus of cos of pi is minus 1, cos of 0 is 1. Okay. Plus this minus 1 is a plus, cos of 2s pi is 1, and cos of pi is minus 1. Is anybody have any problem with these values? This will be 4. Okay, this is the you can say this is for numerator. Okay, this is numerator. Denominator will be 0 to twice pi f to square t dt. Okay, similarly you can find this. This will be sine square t t dt. Sine square t means you have to break it 1 by half 1 minus cos twice t dt, and when you solve this you will get pi. Okay, this term will come 0, and here is plus pi, so it will give the pi only. So what will be the c on 2 then? If you write it's 2 equation 2, and if you give this is 1 equation, this 2 will be c 1 2. Now numerator is 4, a denominator is pi. Okay, 4 by pi. So atake or this approximation, that's equation 1, equation 1 will be give f 2 can be represent with sin t like this, f t equal to sin t. Okay, this should be approximation. The question has already asked to approximate, that's why we have to give approximation symbol here. So f t equal to approximate 4 by pi sin t. Okay, this is the approximation. If we represents a square wave in terms of sine wave, okay, this is the case. It's over. Last year, please keep the attendance also. Oh, it's given already. It's over. So similar question. Okay, the square function. So just try to the similar function. Ft is given. Similar question 1 and minus 1. 0 t pi 0 t pi twice pi. Okay, same question has given, f t is given, and f to t is given. Okay, f to it is given suppose F2T is sin T plus sin 2ST plus sin 3ST, then what will be the waveform or what will be the approximation term? Okay, we we'll just try to find. What do we mean by approximation? Let me say once again, by graphical concepts. So try this one. Suppose this square function has to be approximate with sine wave. Means if we replace this square in place of sine, then our resultant sine will come like this. Okay, and this thing is nothing but pi by 4 sin t. Okay, understood? So similarly, okay, similarly, if we add more sine, if you orthogonal function, if you take more, because here n are not equal, that's why the sin t and sin 2 is 2 would be orthogonal, two orthogonal function, then our resultant function would be like this. It's going to equal with the square wave, almost, okay? For graphical representation, I am showing for you concept only. Sin 2ST, if we take another orthogonal function 3ST, then our function would be, our waveform would be like this. It's going to be approach to square wave. Like that, if we increasing the sine wave or orthogonal function, then it's going to be a square wave only, okay? This is the concept. This is the approximation I'm taking. I'm teaching. So I think is there any doubt till now?